Hey guys, welcome back. Alien360, your host. Thank you so much for joining me. And we're going to pick up The Walking Dead here where we left off on chapter 3, or episode 3. And without further delay, let's get right into this. Been a really awesome game so far. Hope you guys are enjoying the walk.
Previously on The Walking Dead.
Get the gates open! We've got wounded!
I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
You've been good to me and my family. You saved Duck from those monsters. And you stood up to Larry at the drugstore. I won't forget that.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
Those look like the people who raided my
Calm
camp.
Calm down, you're paranoid.
Fuck you!
Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
That's right. I know who you are, and I know you're a killer.
He's not dead! Somebody help me!
Come on! We know this guy's not gonna make it!
No!
Sounds like a car.
It's a shitload of food and supplies back here.
You're right. We shouldn't take this.
The rest of us are taking this stuff.
Don't worry, little girl. Bandits got their eye on that dairy. As long as they keep getting food from them, you'll be safe.
Alright, can't wait to see what's next in line for us here. Going into town for something.
Looks like this is our lucky day.
I don't like it. Keep your eyes open, all right?
Just trying to be optimistic.
Let's just get inside.
Shopping for her, hunting for supplies.
Lee, where do you come down on staying or going?
You mean packing up the motel and getting in the RV?
Yeah, we've been talking about it, but you made up your mind yet?
We should go. Motels run its course, and it's not safe.
You're damn right it has. We pile into the RV and don't pull over till we see water. And if Lily's dead set on staying, then, well, that's the way it goes.
Yeah, I think Lily's on her last leg anyway. She's kind of losing it.
Into the pharmacy and scrape together whatever supplies are left.
We didn't leave much in there.
Hey, we're out of options. Something's better than nothing. Shit.
You okay?
The ladder's come loose. I'm not sure how many more trips she's got in her.
I'm not sure how many more trips we've got in us.
No kidding.
All right, here we go. Up the ladder. Something tells me that ladder's not gonna hold him, though. Nope.
Looks like she's had it.
What now?
I'll find another way up.
Better get a move on.
There's no safe way through that mess.
Wow, we got a winch here. We can try to.
Lily's not doing so good, huh?
It's not good. I'm worried.
No, it's not. I hope she doesn't snap. I might have saved our lives in that meat locker, you know?
Yeah, I feel bad about that, but I was with Kenny. You couldn't take a chance on that guy turning and being locked in a room with him. It may have been the wrong choice, but...
They're blocked by all the fallen concrete.
Upset with me for taking stuff out of that car last week?
I hope not.
She'll get there. Duck was asking about that guy at Herschel's farm last night.
Really? I wasn't sure it fazed him.
Of course it did.
It was a scary situation for him, Sean dying and all.
I'm just worried he'll always think it was his fault.
You're sure you're up for this?
Lee, I'm fine. I've got this. Give me your hand.
Shit! You got this, huh?
Next time I'm bringing Ben. Help me get out.
No! No! Go away! Go! Go! Help me! Somebody help me! Oh God! Oh God!
What the hell is that? A walker?
Walkers don't scream, do they?
Jesus, I don't think so.
She's gonna get us killed!
No shit. And actually...
Oh, she's already bit. She's done.
Fuck. Gotta shoot her. Put her out of this misery.
I don't know we're here.
What do you mean?
I mean, we leave her alive, and she draws them all to her, buying us time.
Yeah.
Think about it. We're always worrying about the ones we can't see. She stays alive and brings them all out of their holes.
Ah, shit.
No! No! Go away! No! Go away! No! Oh, God!
Oh. Fuck, man, you're not hitting anything.
Well, shit, I can't let her suffer.
No, no, no!
Kenny will be pissed, but...
God damn it.
I can't let her suffer, sorry. You know what, Kenny? Sorry, guy. I'm not gonna do that. Couldn't save her, so the best thing was to put her out of her misery. I mean, she was gonna turn. She was already bitten. Put us at risk, but...
Fuck! Incoming! Come on, Lee! Dirty as hell, but we ain't got much time. Get everything you can out of these racks. Don't forget underneath the counter this time. I'll clear down here and then we gotta go.
Try to get as much as we can here in the amount of time we got.
Help!
You're back. Ben found some stickers in a drawer, and I put them on my walkie.
Hey, sweet pea. That's neat. I'll find you in a minute.
Looks like we got the kid on watch again.
What'd you get?
We might as well leave a sign out that says the men are gone. Come and rape our women and children.
Huh. So, what did you get?
Just what was left.
Which was a lot, actually. Take a look. We're fine, by the way.
Nice work. This'll keep us going. If we carry on like this, we'll get through the winter here.
The winter? We'll freeze our asses off here!
His piling into an RV with you two, after what you did to my dad, is so appealing.
Why wouldn't it be? You know I'll do what it takes to keep everyone safe.
We're already safe.
We do whatever is best for the kids. Doesn't that make sense?
It's suicide out there.
We'll die in here.
You're right. You could see someone sleeping and kill one of us. At it again, are we?
Can it, Carly?
Don't boss people around.
I'm sorry. Somebody needs to make executive decisions for the group, though. And I don't think you're capable anymore.
Everything can't come down to the same disagreement. Lily, Kenny's got some legit points here.
I'm so tired of it being you two versus me.
Damn it. I'm not on anyone's side, Lily. These decisions affect everyone.
What about the food situation? What about protection? What about when this place falls? Somebody's got to be thinking about this shit.
How has this not been working? We have everything we need.
Because of me, Lily.
That's BS, Kenny. And you...
We deal with shit as it comes, just like we always do.
And when 15 bandits hop over that wall in the middle of the night? What then? You just gonna deal with that?
Everything that happens to us is another excuse for you to pull this crap about
leaving. I say we deal with it when it happens.
What we want is a week of peace, of not hearing it.
We wouldn't even be fighting about our medicine and supply stocks if Lee hadn't fucked up downtown.
What do you mean?
Some girl came screaming out of an alley. She had dead hanging all over her. She was making enough noise that we would have had plenty of time to get what we needed. Instead, smart guy shot her.
He what?
He put her out of her misery. Stupid.
I couldn't let her suffer.
We're all suffering.
Some more than others.
We've been putting our lives on the line doing these runs into the city. You wouldn't believe the shit we see.
We all appreciate it, Ken.
Y'all should be giving Lee hell for not doing what needed to be done.
It's not so easy for him.
Look, Macon and its people aren't savable. It's not a town. It's full of walkers. And the people who were left are dying and wandering out onto the streets. It's hell on earth. And it's coming. This way.
It's not going to be easier out on the road!
How would you know?
What I know? I know you're not above murder. I know somebody has been stealing our supplies. That's right, stealing! And I know the list of people I can trust here gets smaller every day! Now everybody get out!
Excuse me, I think she's losing it.
She'll get over it.
She's riling everybody up otherwise.
You understand, Ken.
She's right about one thing. None of this is getting any easier.
Things are coming to a head.
You could say that.
Well, I think you did good today. And I find myself thinking that most days.
Thanks.
It's probably worth following up with Lily about what she was saying about missing supplies. With her wound up the way she is, I don't want to see her paranoid.
No question.
And I'd like to talk when you've got a minute.
Sure. Aw, oh, JC's got a crush. She's after me. Alright. Well, let's talk to everybody, see what's happening.
Hey, Clementine.
Hey, Lee.
What's that you're working on, Clem?
It's called a leaf rubbing. My teacher, Miss Moore, showed us how to do them when we went to the botanical garden once. See? It's the same. Kind of.
Now that's really something.
I'll make one for you too.
Do you like it here?
I don't like it here.
Do you want to leave?
Where are we going?
Somewhere else.
I don't know. Maybe if I knew where?
Yeah, that'd be a good thing to know. I'll talk to you later, Clem.
Okay.
Well, I guess let's go check out this shit she's saying about stealing supplies. Somebody stealing supplies. Don't want starting a bunch of shit.
I'm sorry.
You don't have to apologize.
Did you come in here to give me hell or to coddle me?
I wanted to follow up on what you said about stolen supplies.
Do you know what's going on?
I don't. I just heard you mention it.
And you came in here to confess?
I'm not stealing shit. I came in here to help.
There's a traitor. Somebody, one of us, out there. He or she or they have been taking things.
For real? Who? What do you got?
Yes, for real. And I don't have shit. I just know.
Lily.
It counts off and it's the good stuff. Antibiotics, oxy, fuck, anything with opium in it.
I see the count, and it's fine.
I keep my own. That one's getting messed with. I'm a fucking mess right now, but I'm not stupid. I know what happens if I start a witch hunt.
So you want me to start one?
I want you to poke around.
What's there to go on?
I found this tossed into the garbage.
Huh.
We don't toss out equipment, we fix it. You'd only try to get rid of a flashlight if you were using it when you shouldn't.
Okay, I'll poke around a little bit.
Thank you. If you don't find anything, I'm just going to assume it's you.
You can assume whatever the hell you want.
A mystery.
Jesus.
I held up.
I'm sorry. I heard you guys talking.
You need to unhear all of that.
Can I help?
What did I just say?
You're the Grace Detective, and I can be Dick Grayson, your ward. That's Robin.
I know who it is. You can help. Don't tell anybody.
Secrecy.
Yeah, good.
What do I do?
I don't know. Go look around. Let me know if you find anything weird.
I'm on the case.
Well, give the kid something to keep him busy. Alright, let's go talk to Carly and see what she wanted to talk to us about.
Talk to Lily yet?
Yeah, she thinks supplies have been walking away.
Really?
There's some broken equipment, too. I'll look into it.
Thanks for doing that. What I wanted to say was, I've been thinking a lot about you.
I think about you, too.
Our group is small.
You're small.
You're a convicted killer.
Carly, Jesus.
And I think people should know. Not because they deserve to, and not because you're a bad man. I think the opposite of those two things. People need to know because we're hanging by a thread here, and I can't see Lily talk about you without thinking it's the next thing she's going to say. You don't have to tell everyone, but think about who you trust and take the opportunity while you have it.
You're probably right.
Of course I'm probably right. People might be pissed, and telling them might cause some trouble, but it will be a far cry from what'll happen if they don't hear it from you.
Yeah.
So you'll do it then?
I'll let people know. You're totally right.
Good. I think it's for the best. Don't call me small. Now, is there anything else you want to talk about?
Do you feel safe here?
Show me a bath with a heated floor and a high-rise apartment and hand me a full-bodied Malbec and then I'll feel safe. I don't know. This place is fine, but we all know that that could change at any second.
You really think people are ready to hear about me?
It's not a matter of ready or not. There's never going to be a good time, but there are going to be a lot of bad ones. Right now doesn't seem like one of them. But everyone's different. Who knows how each person would take it, you know? Maybe it's worth thinking about who you want to tell.
I'm gonna look into this thing.
Good idea.
All right, guys, let's go. Who should we tell? I'm thinking Clementine, but we already told her, I think.
Clem, I need to talk to you for a second.
Okie dokie.
The day you and I met, I was in a car accident.
I remember. Your leg was bleeding.
The car I was in was a police car, and I was on my way to jail for committing a crime. I need to tell you now, because I don't want you to hear it any other way.
Okay.
Do you have anything to say?
I don't think so.
You can go on back to your things.
And I think that I should let Kitty and Katya know.
Hey, you two. How are you doing?
We're okay.
Just having a little spat.
We all carry guns now, and I don't like it.
It's the way it's gotta be.
I know, but I'm not getting used to it. I'm sorry. How are you, Lee?
Kenny, you got a second? I need to tell you something.
Sure, pal. What you got?
It's serious.
Oh, no. What'd the she-devil do to you?
Shut up, man. I killed someone. Different than Larry or the St. John's. Different from everything. This was before the Walkers. I know. I didn't say anything when I met you because I was with the girl and, you know, I was worried.
I just smashed a guy's head in with a 50-pound block of salt. You saw me do that, right?
Yeah, I did.
And you're talking about who we were? The fuck does that matter? It's everything this mess has got us doing now, Lee. Shit. Look, is Duck safe around you?
Of course.
Then shut it. You don't owe anybody any kind of explanation.
Hi, guys. Can I talk to you about something?
Sure. Is everything okay?
I don't want to keep it from her either, so...
I was, on my way to prison 3 months ago. You've always looked at me with kind eyes. I wonder if you could still do that if you, knew I was a convicted felon.
My goodness, for what? How much trouble can a teacher get into?
Well, plenty. But it had nothing to do with that. It was for murder.
Why?
He and my wife,
That's enough. Tell me what happened when you were locked in the fridge at the dairy.
I held Lily back, and Kenny made sure Larry didn't get up.
What did he do?
He smashed his head in.
She had a right to know. Excuse me. She had a right to know that.
Everything keeps changing.
I I'm not gonna tell the kid. It ain't none of his damn business. Looks like a signal to me.
Pink.
Doc.
A clue.
Maybe.
What do you think it is?
I don't think it's anything.
Maybe it's a sign.
It could be. It's pink chalk, which is weird.
Okay, back to investigating.
Where's come down here? Right?
Do you have any pink chalk?
No, it's gone somewhere. Do you want blue?
No, it's okay.
Psst, Lee. I found something.
What is it?
I found this piece of pink chalk and a scuff of it over by the gate.
Really?
Totally. I was combing the scene for clues and...
Yeah, Duck, I got it. Good job.
Cool.
Damn, this kind of sucks that somebody's stealing.
See, I did good, huh?
Yeah, Duck, you did. I suppose I should go out there and look around. You stay here this time. Seriously.
Okay.
Oh, hey, I didn't want to do that. Thought he was going out there to check.
Those bandits gave us hell, but they've been quiet for days now. There's a grate down there.
Oh, shit. Snap.
Son of a bitch.
You haven't come up with anything, have you?
I came up with this. It's got a bunch of meds in it. It was in a grate on the outside wall. And there's a sign on the other one.
Holy fuck.
Yeah.
Okay, we line everybody up. Everybody. Somebody is killing us. Stealing from that supply is the same as slipping into your room at night and cutting your throat while you sleep. You die. What is the difference? What if Clementine gets sick and we don't have what we need? What the hell?
You don't fucking steal from us!
Who the fuck is that?
We got our people out there. We ain't fucking around!
What do we do?
Oh, Lily. Shit! They're gonna start kicking indoors any second.
Lily, what the hell are you-
Stall him.
What?
Just keep him talking. Do whatever it takes to stop him pulling the trigger.
You made the biggest mistake of your life!
Shit.
Enough of this bullshit! Drew, stop putting your boot to these doors!
Yeah!
Hold it, asshole!
Take it easy. We have more supplies. We can keep the deal going.
Too late, shithead! We ain't giving second chances.
It was a mix-up. We'll make it worth your while.
I'm listening.
What will it take to reach a deal?
About twice as much as you've been giving us.
You got it. Done.
Is that so? Well, I suppose we ought to hash out some terms then.
I don't like no hands.
And shut up, Ron! Christ!
Oh, shit!
Damn, this thing ain't easy to aim.
Now, get over here, hurry!
May have me save our asses.
Get inside!
Hi there, me!
Help!
Gotcha, hang on!
Where is he? He's hiding behind that van. Get your asses around behind.
Come on! Cliff, get inside the RV! It's gonna be okay! Go!
Ah, shit!
Lily, get in the RV!
Screw her! Let her stay!
Get down here!